working of heart. Heart during its normal activities, the impure or deoxygenated blood collected from all the body parts that enters in the right atrium through two big arteries. These are called superior vena cava and inferior vena cava. Superior vena cava and inferior vena cava, they are so called because superior, because this superior vena cava that carries blood of the head and arm region, and these organs, the head and you see the arms, they are superior than the heart level. Thus this vein is called superior vena cava. This is a inferior vena cava. It is inferior so called because the lower body parts, the legs and all other body parts which lie lower the heart level, the blood from all these lower body parts that is carried to the right atrium of the heart through this vein, that is inferior vena cava. The impure blood or deoxygenated blood that is carried to right atrium of the heart. When the right atrium contracts, the blood is forced to the right ventricle through tricuspid wall. When this right ventricle that gets filled with the blood, it contracts, forcing the blood to the lungs through pulmonary artery. Pulmonary artery, or we can say that pulmonary aorta, for purification. When this right ventricle contracts, when this right ventricle contracts, the tricuspid wall that shuts down, that meaning it closes, thus preventing the blood to flow back towards the right atrium. And thus the blood flows to the lungs through pulmonary aorta. Here in the lungs, the carbon dioxide gas diffused into the air present in the lungs and oxygen present in the lungs, that gas diffused into the blood, and thus the oxygen, the blood that becomes oxygenated, and that oxygenated blood from the lungs that is returned back to the heart through two veins. These veins are called pulmonary. These veins are called pulmonary veins. Pulmonary veins. Two pulmonary veins coming from the lungs. The pure blood, oxygenated blood from the lungs that enters the left atrium of the heart through two pulmonary veins. When this left atrium contracts, the pure blood is forced to the left ventricle and through the wall called bicuspid wall. When this left ventricle gets filled with the pure blood, it contracts. At this time of contraction of left ventricle, the bicuspid wall or mitral wall that becomes closed and forcing the blood to all the body parts through big artery called systemic aorta, and the blood in all the body parts that gives oxygen to the body parts and thus again becomes deoxygenated, carries carbon dioxide, and thus blood is now called deoxygenated or impure blood. That impure blood that enters the right atrium through superior and inferior vena cava, thus is recited. Dear students, thank you very much. Inshallah, we will discuss it in a next lecture. Thank you.